I don't know what's going on.
Hey, I was gonna make a sandwich too.
What is wrong with this? This is so terrible.
Dude, YouTube sucks.
Stupid.
Oh, we're finally doing this, are we? Because I was going to make a sandwich.
Arnado.
Okay.
What is this crap?
Let's do it.
How's my hair look? Terrible.
What do I think about
Dave. Oh, I
heroes?
need a.
Well, we've all seen them, haven't we? Swanning about the place with
Hopefully,
their
that's not.
disproportionately high cheekbones and comically massive weapons.
Wanker.
Roughing up bandits, because they like to rough up bandits, don't they? Living it up with the common folk every single night.
Oh, God.
On a
Dude, I'm waking up too
basis,
early for this.
Two heroes me, someone
oh,
who's
maybe I'm not waking up early
fruit,
enough.
With
God
veg
damn.
On the agricultural side of things.
Just look at them.
Not wafting
not
around mythical creatures.
Ready. All right, hold on. Is this
That's
all
what
correct?
They are.
Yeah.
Wafters.
Yeah, well done.
Well,
you see, I'm not here to slay legendary beasts.
That's not gonna
I'm
work,
here
that's not
to cull
gonna
for
work.
Vegetable,
Dude,
not a euphemism.
YouTube streaming
Let's face
sucks.
It, the age of heroes is over. This is the age of innovation.
Is this Fable?
This, if you will, is the age of death. One moment.
Or is this the Jolly Green Giant? Jack and the Beanstalk.
This is awkward.
Yeah.
Feeling the beanstalk? It looks like something in the beanstalk.
Oh.
It is Fable! That's funny. I know nothing about Fable, honestly. Besides people eating sandwiches on glasses, day one game pass. Alright, hold on, let me get my, I didn't have time to do anything. Just kind of rolled out of bed, get into a shower. I look like crap. How is it now? Better? Whatever. I can't hear shit. I need some, what are they called? Headphones. I had rape for cool. This looks like a retelling of The Last of Us 2. Nice.
Death don't have no mercy in this land. Death don't have no mercy in this land.
Question is this gonna reach? I hope so.
You come to your house and it won't stay long.
One of these stupid things to the bitch.
And somebody be gone. You don't have no mercy.
Yeah, of course, it's barely been reached.
Shaking bones. Been a while.
Who?
So, you remember that favor you owe me?
No, I do not.
I'm looking for a creature. Huge, sneaky. Teeth like knives.
He looks like a squidbilly.
No?
It's about forget o'clock.
Well, hey, how about you guys?
Vegeta? What are they talking about? Vegeta? Showcase
no.
better. PlayStation?
Nobody?
Get the fuck out of here. Spider-Man 2? What are they talking about?
Not helpful. Sneaky.
Very. South of Midnight. I mean, they showed nothing but a CG trailer, which is not really helping anything, but whatever. The world looks interesting enough. Art style. premiere. I gotta turn. I can't hear shit.
These are dangerous times. At least that's what I hear.
You heard wrong.
The Empire? They're everywhere.
God, this is not long enough.
But the world here belongs to the syndicates.
The who? I said the who?
If I want to survive, I have to play their game.
It's just doing it. Yeah, whatever. Not really.
Looks like I'm all in.
Are you?
She's in here somewhere.
On second thought.
I like how she pointed her out like immediately. Was this Bounty Hunter Extreme? And of course you get a cute little pet. That's cool. Everyone loves that.
I've been held back my whole life.
Poker. Oh, Pazok. That'd be sick. If they bring back Pazok.
Here to offer you a way out, okay?
Oh, yeah?
Get off my ship, Jaylen.
Give me a chance.
You're gonna have giving you chances.
It'll be dangerous, risky.
You got a cool droid with a nice duster look over your jacket. Again.
Shows no mercy.
Don't really pay $10 to say PlayStation is the best. Risk it all. That's amazing. Star Wars Outlaws, cool. Woke. Ultra woke. I mean, look cool. Regardless of wokeness, I don't think it's woke, but. That could be the who knows.
Wow.
Who is this?
South of Midnight.
Shadowbomb.
Star Wars Outlaws. Welcome to our first ever double feature, the Xbox Game Showcase, followed by a deep dive into one of the most important RPGs ever made. Starfield.
Star Wars? Oh. Like Star Wars?
Powerful wall entertainment. It transforms.
I've never played Starfield. I don't even know what it is.
And it's just incredibly and awesomely fun. That is why Team Xbox is committed to building the greatest place to play. By partnering with the most ambitious of game creators and by unleashing the power of the gaming community, enabling all of us to play the games we want with our friends anywhere, from mobile devices to PCs to consoles.
To PCs.
The lineup
I know,
we
keep
have
doing
for you today is just incredible.
These
are the works of the very greatest creative teams from around the world. We made this show for you, the largest, most engaged, and globally diverse fan base in Xbox history.
History.
You are the heart and soul of Xbox. Your passion drives us, and you are the inspiration for the visionaries whose games we showcase today. From me and all of the team at Xbox, thank you.
Hey, you're welcome.
This next game is from Thunder Lotus, the award-winning studio behind Spiritfarer, who've gone back to their combat roots with an amazing co-op raid-focused action game that is uniquely
combat
theirs.
Raid-focused action.
All right, everybody.
Co-op RPG. I hate all that nonsense. Honestly, the games of crafting all fucking. It's like, bro. Just give me the weapon. I don't want to have to fucking do all this crazy shit. Don't give me 20 versions of the same gun. And you have to like scatter through looking for which one would be the best one out of the 50 that you just picked up. Like, oh my fucking god, man, please. I wish there was like a auto like, you know, just, I don't know, just make it strong as I go, whatever. Or just give me better powers. I hate numbers popping up all day. It's like, oh my god. This at least doesn't have stupid numbers popping up. Like, oh my god, man. It's so annoying. Alright, what is this? This looks like Hades or something. It's like a Castlevania themed music. Three immortals kill. Yeah, nothing too crazy, but whatever. It's another game. I'm sure there's a group for that.
All right, guys, it's a simple job.
Ooh, payday? Wow.
Just in and out. Nothing to it.
I don't think I've ever played a payday game.
Floor.
I mean, they seem like they should be cool, right? You're sitting robbing banks and stuff. That's kind of cool. Oh, are they ever, like, co-op? Like, online co-op? They must be co-op. I couldn't believe this game would not be co-op. Oh, you get to be the cops too, maybe? Is that what it is? So, like, a more fun version of that stupid game? Siege? Payday 3, coming September 21st to Xbox Game Pass. Cool.
World premiere.
Yeah, I would play that. It's not... Siege is... so annoying. I want something like simple. You just go in and just do it. Don't, like, I have to pick all these weird things and... all these idiots know how to do this. It's like, oh my god. This is Persona. I've never played a Persona game either. And still to this day, I kinda don't plan to. I mean, the art style and everything looks cool. The menus look nice. They look fun and like engaging. But I don't know, the game. Yeah, apparently it's a RPG. I had no idea until like maybe 6 months ago. It's an actual RPG. It might be good because so many people say good things about it. Man, this is a Game Pass extravaganza. Not a world premiere? See,
people don't like you very much, do they?
No, not really.
Sent here to the living lands.
Skull and Bones, though, it says. You man? Assassin's Creed?
To invest investigate some plague that seems to be corrupting a very
corrupting
souls.
Corruption. Oh my god, dude, he got the big boot to the fucking face. Oh my god, just for that alone.
You scare us. The way you fight.
Brutal. Why does this look like that Oblivion or something? Skyrim.
Destroy us.
Oh my god, Forge. Oh, Forge your. Okay, there we go. Destiny.
But now that you have all this power, what are you gonna do with it?
Kill a whole bunch of savage wolves. And read books. Avowed. I'm sure they showed this, I just don't remember. Coming 2024. Play it day one with Game Pass. Cool. I wonder what this will be. Rare. Lucasfilms? Really? Dude, I haven't played Sea of Thieves in so long. Lucasfilms though? What are they doing? Oh, is it like a tie-in? Monkey Island? What?
Welcome to the Scum Bar, the most notorious tavern on Melee Island. Wall-to-wall rogues and scoundrels.
So tell me, which ship is right for you? A big ship? A luxury ship? A ship with just a splash of je ne sais quoi?
Told us name.
Monkey Island. You mean Governor Guybrush. But Freeport's not set foot out of that mansion for almost a year.
Hey, what do you think you're doing? I told you no autographs.
I'm playing with my
toys. Have a meet and greet ticket. And I guess it's not every day that you get to meet the mighty pirate Guybrush Threepwood. The legend of Monkey Island.
Who? Nice. I mean, at least he had underwear, to be honest with you. He wasn't just sitting there with his twig and berries just hanging.
Well, well, what do we have here?
You need these.
I don't know, I always find the CG trailers way better than the game sometimes. It'd be cool if it wasn't first person. Hey, a new original story for free. Oh wow, coming fairly soon. About a month away. Cool. I should really play Sea of Thieves. I don't know why I don't. World premiere. Oh, here we go. Give me something good. All right. You like to see it? Asobo? I don't know if you love to see that. Microsoft Flight Center. Okay, really? It's your dream of a career in aviation? What? Flight simulator career? Probably. Oh, they're making flight simulator a little more fun then? Instead of just literally just fucking flying? Get to rescue people? That sounds cool. That's a pretty good expansion. Helicopter cargo transport? I don't know about that. That doesn't sound that fun. I want to drive an ambulance around and rescue people. I don't know if I want to dust the crops, man. Jesus Christ. So have a fucking career in aviation. but not get paid for it. Pay them. That's cool. What the hell is that thing? Looking like Mastermind or Big Brain or whatever. Hey, nice. Expensive car. So, it's career oriented. I mean, that's kind of cool because it gives you kind of like a storyline, because nothing else in that game is just do whatever you want. It's like no parameters, just try your best. This actually sounds, at least seems a little bit more like engaging. But it's literally just have a job in aviation. I don't know if I'm going to do that. It'd be Flight Career Simulator. I mean, whatever. It seems cool enough. What the hell? Oh, is that from Dune? Yeah, I think that's kind of a good idea. Add these stupid shits in there. Yeah, they should have tie-ins. That would actually make sense. Like, do like Fortnite and just like add a whole bunch of like crazy like planes in there. Like add the Pelican. I don't know. Add Star Wars stuff. Anything that has flying vehicles. I mean, honestly, I don't know what you would do, though. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what you just, I guess you just fly and just terrorize the neighborhood.
Hi, Melina here, speaking to you from our performance capture stage at Ninja Theory, Ooh. Where we have just wrapped our shoots for Senua Saga Hellblade 2. When we first showed gameplay for Hellblade 2, it was a look at some of the game's cinematic and immersive action, where Senua faced off against a gigantic troll on the Icelandic coastline.
Oh my god, what is that?
Today, we're taking you deeper into Senua's story, her personal quest, her unique perspective on the world, and the intimate journey that awaits you in Senua Saga. What you'll see today is all captured by the team on Xbox Series X.
Cool. All right.
She can feel.
Hopefully, they actually put a lot of like gameplay mechanics into the game.
Following the threads of her mind, she's here to find them.
Man, I want to see this in 4K. This is in HD, it says, but... Oh, great. I mean, she did a lot of grunting in this. Kind of, huh? I'm not gonna lie.
But it's never so simple, is it?
Never.
Wisdom has a price. And there's always a part of you that changes.
Oh my god. What is that? Big... Anus cavities all up in the thingy. Over there. I wonder if they're using tech from Forza.
I can feel them everywhere. The lost ones, they are watching us.
Jesus, that's fucking gross. Look at that. Man, you did not want to see that.
They can see us.
Ooh. Dude, this shit's giving me the willies. MSR of the game.
What are you waiting for?
I'm here.
Watching more than one.
I know you.
Where are they?
Where are you?
What do they want?
I don't like it. I'm scared.
This is too
mad.
Their eyes everywhere can feel them boring into her. What is she supposed to do?
Do something. Oh, ask them. Yeah. What do you want me to do?
I wonder. I don't know how they did this. I wonder if it's just like transitions. You were lost. Not anymore. Or if the whole thing is just a cutscene. To the point. I hear you on that, man. I mean, they're just trying to show off how cool it looks, I guess. But how much does it count if you're not playing? I think Hideo Kojima had a hand in this game.
Ready.
She's starting to believe.
Who are these around you, Senua? Those you have saved, or those you led to death?
I appreciate that they showed something, but they showed nothing at the same time. Come on, man, what are we doing? Is it still going? Definitely. Imagine. She wakes up into like a beach on Miami. What is this, jacuzzi? Drunk again, I see. Look at them buns. Oh man, buns everywhere. Buns out. Look at them. Just twig and berries hanging. Honestly, this is what Senua Sacrifice could use. Some, like, Japanese comedy, man. This shit's too good, man. Oh my god, he's not shaved!
Turns up, dude! Yeah, dude! Hang loose, bro!
He doesn't know that he's naked? I don't get it. He probably has a crab stuck to him. Nope, never mind. That would have been funny if there was like a crab on it. Infinite wealth? What? I don't get it. I mean, I liked the trailer, it was funny, but I don't get what just happened. I guess you had to play the other game. Super based. The Call of 76? Oh my god, don't tell me it's Fallout 76. Can't be. It is! Wonderland of promise plucked from post-atomic blight. The fruit of years of prudent progress and determined reclamation and 15 million dwellers worth of keen imagination. From the heart of West Virginia to the depths of the pit. Well, we owe it all to Vault 76. No matter if you roam alone or spend your time with friends. Are they really doing something with 76 again? There are relics to uncover from a time before the war, along with loads of friendly folks to meet. And I thought this game was a dud. Our world is always changing. Greater foes are overthrown as we embark on expeditions into thrilling new unknowns. Yes, from Appalachian settlements to Nuka World on tour. You're never short on things to do or places to explore. Very right, cool, man. All, eh?
Well, how about this? Pack your bags for an escape of Epicurean bliss.
Put your rad shield on and fix your hair up pretty, because we're headed for the boardwalk of Atlantic City.
Ooh.
So there you have it. Now you know.
Time to gamble.
There's a million ways to make the wasteland your waste home. And when you hear adventure calling, when you're looking for some kicks, answer the call of Vault.
Answer the call of Vault.
Answer the call of Vault 76.
Nice.
Play it now with Xbox Game Pass.
Now? I mean, I guess it is 76. Is this coming soon? I guess the expansion is soon, but you can play 76 now. That's lame. Oh my god. This would be sick if it was Sekiro 2. Yeah, definitely not. Capcom? Onimusha 5? I don't know. Yeah, that's a game that they should redo, is Onimusha. Either remake or just make a new, I guess. Is it Onimusha? I don't know what this is. Onimusha Online? I mean, whatever this is, it seems pretty sick. Okay, it's not Onimusha. Maybe it's Oni. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what this could be. What does Capcom make? Path of the Goddess? Oh, it's just a whole new game in general. Okay. Play day one with Game Pass. I don't know. That looks kind of good. The art style looks nice. Bright colors. Samurai stuff. Looks sick. I was hoping it'd be an Onimusha thing, but I don't know.
General Motors' commitment to performance is embodied in two of its iconic brands, Chevrolet and Cadillac.
Is it Sportza? Sportza!
The V-Series.R elevates Cadillac's competitive spirit to a whole new level with its thunderous V8 and hybrid power.
Thundercats!
The legendary Corvette has been a celebrated champion for decades.
Oh yeah?
The all-new Chevrolet Corvette E-Ray continues that tradition.
Does it though?
General Motors is proud to usher in a new era of competition with the innovators behind the new
Power Rangers China Force. That's sick. For the other game, I'm sure.
Forza Motorsport and General Motors are pairing their strengths in technical excellence and sophisticated modern design.
Is that the actual
to take
car or the game?
To the future and bring that experience to gamers. I'm thrilled to welcome the Cadillac V-Series.R and the Corvette E-Ray to the home of competition.
Forza. Forza! This is a poor choice of cars, though, honestly.
I know you're ready. You've got this.
I mean, I guess they're both American companies, whatever. Kind of makes sense.
Let's tweak the car's performance for the next one.
Ugh, that's what I hate about these games. Hey, let's fix the suspension, let's add this, let's stiffen that, like, oh my, bro, oh my, please. Just let me race the goddamn car. And give me, like, the best version. I mean, I get that, you know, people want to piecemeal it, build it from scratch. Have that, but there's idiots out here that just want to have fun and play the game. And that idiot would be me. Like, I don't have time to deal with all this shit. I don't want to deal with all this. You know what I mean? And I don't want to pay to fucking skip the grind. Like, I just want to play the game and just have fun. And I get that you can, you know, do it the way that it's intended. That's fine. But just have it like, hey, you want the ultimate version? Just, and just play, you know? But, you know, obviously you can't have ranked or whatever. I don't know, whatever. But just do something like that. Just make it accessible for everyone just to be able to play and have fun.
I have seen all that ever was and all that ever will be. I have seen betrayal. Endurance.
What is this? ES6? What does that mean? Halo 7? Nice. I think so. Whoa, what was he riding? What was that, a dinosaur? Dude, that'd be sick if they had games that had, like, mini dinosaurs. Like, you could ride a T-Rex, but it wasn't as big as a normal T-Rex, just like a mini version of a T-Rex. Something like that.
First time in my unending existence, I feel disconnected from fate's flow. Unseen forces move against me, hungry for forbidden.
Mid the game. Be funny.
Kept hidden, a secret that threatens to unravel reality itself.
What is ESO? Oh, Elder Scrolls Online. Is that what this is? I thought that's what the Fable game was. Yeah, this kind of looks like it could be Elder Scrolls.
Protect the secret.
Secrets. Doom 6 all the way. One Piece. Valorant 3, yes. Nostalgia bait. Elder Scrolls Online Necron. So it is Elder Scrolls. Shadow over Morrowind? What? I didn't see anything that had to do with Lord of the Rings.
Toronto was under attack.
Maybe I missed it.
By Null Sector.
There's something different about Null Sector this time.
Oh, this is Overwatch?
They've taken over most of the city and they're rounding up Omnix. They need our help.
Hubert. Yeah, big skip. We're up Z's, homie.
So much to teach them.
Dead game. Is it dead? I don't know. I'm sure people still play it.
If we can stop Null Sector, maybe we can save the city.
Coming through!
Do they have Valorant on console?
As if I didn't have enough problems already.
I feel like this is like Valorant. Where am I mistake? I've never played Valorant.
So
I just heard of it.
Interrupt the moment, but I'm picking up reports of more attacks in other cities.
Okay, we good. Overwatch Gundam Edition.
I say let's give it to him.
New ways to play. Flashpoint game mode. What does that mean? Hero Mastery.
Time to create
co-op events. Ooh. That sounds fun. I mean, kind of. Firing range. Story missions. Ooh.
The world is counting on us.
Overwatch, a new animation again. Cool. I guess. I don't like the art style. Looks too generic to me, personally.
Let's go.
Shall we do this together?
Fight with me!
Engaging.
Watch this!
Are they new?
I saw that. Not bad.
New heroes, starter pack. I mean, whatever. I don't know. World. I'm sure there's plenty of people that love that. Double, triple, quadruple me.
What is this place?
Persona again.
Ooh. You're telling me you're thieves who steal hearts.
Oh my god, dude. What are these games called that like have the little blocks where you can move? I hate them.
Just as the Phantom Thieves have helped the Rebel Corps. Never forget that we're a united force who can rely on each other. You should be grateful to have been made my subjects. But you're just matterless little brats. Unfortunately, returning will be no easy feat.
No, it shan't. It shan't. I like the cat, though. The cat's cool, man.
Can't go on like this. So, will you take a stand beside us?
I don't know about the little chibi looks to them. Whatever. Persona Tactica? Ooh. Ugh. Man, the Z's are right. Holy shit, I'm about to pass out. I can't believe they're showing this in San Diego. That was the nearest theater. Man, I'm glad I didn't try to go. Holy shit. Oh my god, Halo 10? Nice.
Humanity has always hunted for knowledge in the unknown.
Or is this
the wonder is
Skyrim? Or Star? Starfield.
The field of stars is so Skyrim. Vast.
I've never played any. Is this the first Starfield? Or is this like. Starfield is new. I have no idea. Skyrim and Fallout 4, brand new universe, 25 years in the making. Yeah, I feel like this game has been since I was a child.
We're all here because we're committed to the biggest question of all.
Dude, they better not fuck this up.
What's out there?
It's gonna be like a No Man's Sky. Hopefully it's good. I mean, I've never I don't know what it's about. I have no clue about it. You're all I know is I will play.
Part of our family.
We do not fully understand all that is at work here.
No finer group in the stars to be unraveling.
Whoa,
this mystery.
Mortal Kombat.
I'll follow you from here on out, Captain.
Thank you.
Grab jump is ready. I love this part.
Oh my god, I feel like I'm
These
freezing.
These artifacts could be everything we've been looking for. Another great secret the universe is asking us to unravel.
No Man's Sky 3, word up. I hope the combat doesn't suck. It looks like it could be okay.
We are not stopping. Whatever lies at the end of this road will change humanity forever.
Okay, from these quick little blurps real fast, I don't know, it looks good. And the way the combat looked, it looked like it would be engaging, not slow and boring.
This is where we belong.
Hopefully it's not, like, sloppy either, though. Like, I don't know, some games are just, like, disconnected. It's just like, you're doing your own thing and it just happens to be shooting somebody. It's like, what? I don't feel like I'm really shooting. Stay tuned at the end of the showcase for Starfield Direct. Okay, cool. Yeah, when did it come out? I thought it was coming out this year.
World premiere.
Let's go. What is this? Oh my god, is this the gunk too? Was this a fake Zelda? Breath of the Kingdom? Have they showed this? Walk Caliber 1? Climbing Simulator? This DLC? Like the best and worst part of Zelda, the climbing. Holy shit, it really is a climbing simulator. Oh my fucking god, what is this? Kojima, did you have a hand in this? Like Death Stranding, only like climbing edition. I don't know. For some reason, I'm vaguely intrigued by this. As dumb as just rock climbing sounds, it's like still a lot of traversal and it looks kind of puzzly too. If it's puzzly, I think it should be fine. Just saying? How do you say that? I don't know. It didn't look bad, I'll tell you that. It looked kind of stupid at the beginning when I thought about it, but then as I saw it, it started to look a little cooler. Secret mode? The Chinese room? What? Oh my god, please don't show some crazy monster. Whoa, is this near Automata? Nope. Oil rig simulator? KI2? I know, right? Dude, Killer Instinct has come up for a long time. Still Wakes the Deep? Early 24. Okay. I don't know. I don't know what the. They didn't really show much. But now that you got me on a Killer Instinct want. Nope. It's not. Dude, they have to find a developer for it. He already said, like, oh, we need a good developer. We don't know who that's going to be. So they're basically waiting on, like, a good developer to make it. All right, cool indie games. I don't like the protagonist. I don't know, she looks not like as interesting. And the world looks like, I don't know, looks like regular world, kind of. I don't know. She looks like just like a normal girl, which is not terrible, but like, I don't know, I want someone that's like, in battle armor. Dungeons of Hinterberg, whatever. I don't know. It's alright.
Hi.
What?
I'm very excited.
What's this idiot doing?
To be returning as Johnny Silverhand.
Man, he's really leaning into this. Expansion
for Cyberpunk 2077. Phantom Liberty.
Phantom Liberty.
This new adventure reunites Johnny and V on a dangerous spy mission. And introduces Idris Elba as secret agent Solomon Reed. It's really amazing to share the screen with you, Idris. It's cool to be a part of this game with you, man. As a player, you'll get to visit Dog Town.
You'll visit all kinds of stuff.
An unexplored part of Night City.
His mannerisms, I don't know, it kind of sells it. It's good.
States of America. Expect a massive expansion.
Yeah, at least he's not stiff. I mean, honestly, he's just very likable. Plenty of seems stuff fun to do.
I know the team at CD Projekt Red just keeps raising the bar when it comes to telling cinematic stories in video games. And I really can't wait for you to play it on Xbox Series X and S.
Oh, yeah?
But enough talking. I'm guessing you want to see for yourself. And so it is my honor and pleasure to give you and introduce the official trailer for Phantom Liberty. Check it out.
Check it out, man. I know you just dipped.
There's got to be a way out of this.
Oh, my God. Super genius, man, when it comes to that.
I'm dying.
Deepfake? Imagine if it was.
V.
That was funny, because it sounded like he was doing a voiceover.
My name is Songbird. I'm an NUS intelligence analyst. I know about the bomb ticking in your head.
I'm assuming they fixed this game, then?
I can save your life.
What's the catch?
I need you to get to Dogtown.
I don't know, I was never intrigued by this game.
Man's got 1,001 reasons to want Myers as a hostage. Sleeper agents. Time to wake them up.
So NUSA's tossing us back into the fray, huh?
Stay sharp. We're in the wolf's den now.
Uh-oh. You get to swim?
Get Myers out.
Did you not be able to before, I guess? I don't know.
Her safety is the top priority. They catch us out here, we're dead. Wait, hear that?
God Almighty, it's moving!
God Almighty, it's moving. That's good, I like that. Yeah, a lot of cinematic stuff.
Someone ratted us out.
Weird gameplay, yeah. Probably the same. Nice jacket, though, I like that.
It's a charade, V.
I don't know, I would wear it, but...
People get hurt. Bodies drop.
Just want what Songbird promised me. The cure.
Situation has changed. You need to know if you're with
as they always do.
The illusion of freedom draws in the desperate.
Hey, baby.
Truth be.
Come on. Got iron in your hand. Gotta put it to someone's head. Pull the trigger.
If I don't do anything and do it soon, I'll die.
Okay. What is happening? Oh. The 26th noise of September. Footage captured in game. We like that. What's this? You can't park too? God, what is this, Sim City? Jesus. No, thank you. It does look good, though. The graphics on it look pretty nice. There's a lot of people that like these type of games. I definitely not want to. Unless you could just, like, blow it up. You know what I mean? Just, I don't know, man. Godzilla just come in and just wreak havoc. Oh, how sweet. Hell no. Oh, no, no, no. I'm not a structural engineer at all, or civil engineer, whatever. I don't know. I wonder if they take this stuff and just, like, I don't know, try to apply it to real life. Excuse me. Uh oh, nuclear plants. Is Homer working there? At least the graphics look really good at it, though. SimCity 5? SimCity 9? Is it even SimCity? Or is it like a new thing? Cities, Skyline 2. Alright, whatever. I mean, it looks impressive, and that helps like the immersion of these type of games. More DLC. The perfect game. All right.
World premiere.
I mean, if you like those, then yeah, it looked like it would be. Atlas. Oh my God, another Persona.
覚えてるか。
国民の信託を最も集めし者が次なる王となる資格を得る者。
That'd be cool if they freaking made
陛下の命が奪われるなど。
The Astral Chain game for every system. Astral Chain 2. So I feel. Is this like a persona? It looks like it. Looks like a persona of different art, slightly different art style. Or is it the same?
この国は今、有史以来の危機にさらされている。どうやら面白い力を手にしたようだ。
主君に捧げると決めた覚悟そのものだ。
これこそ人
間の真実だ。 Yeah, so alternate dimension? Alternate dimension? Persona?
やはり君は興味深い。
今こそあんた自身がそうなる前に。
正義かどうかじゃない。
誰もが恐れと不安に負けそうで。
理想を貫け。
何が正しいのかわからない。
全ての始まりは。
I mean, honestly, this looks a little more appealing than Persona to me. Metaphor? Cool. Re-Fantasio? Alright, look cool.
World premiere.
Good Xbox showcase saved. Final Fantasy? I don't know. Ooh, is this a new Ori? Banner Saga, what is that?
Humanity's cities have fallen. Our people's only means of survival is to seek sanctuary here, in the Belfry.
The Belfry? Uh-oh.
We must explore this world.
Hell no.
To find the origins of this evil.And bring hope back to our people.
Co-op and Ventur. What is this, like Castle Crashers? I mean, I don't know. Doesn't look that appealing, honestly.
Together, you can save humanity.
Cool. Towerborn? Nah, I'm alright. Looks too generic, honestly. I mean, not bad, whatever. I'm sure it's fine to play. But just not really catching my eye.All right, here we go. It's got to be something good. This looks familiar.
This city.It's a miracle of progress. A finely
tuned, BioShock?
Delicately balanced machine.
BioShock? Question marks? Yeah, it looks like it would be a BioShock game.
But it only takes one rebellious little gear to ruin everything.
Lady Rottenwood? Nice.
If you resist my rule,
definitely Bioshock.
If you alter our past, if you threaten what I have,
Wolfshock. Please be Bioshock.
There is nowhere in space or time where I will not destroy you.
Oh no. What did I do?
Biowolf. Words. Of course.
Before my friend puts one in your scalp.
That's there. Clock work. Nice. Revolution. Coming in due time. Sick. Got him. Coming in due time, bitches.
Thank you all for joining
us. Oh, yeah, it's not bad. Oh, my God. Are you kidding me?
For me and the team.
Come on, Phil.
I'm excited to see 11 games showcased from our first party studios. We opened with Fable from Playground Games, which will bring the franchise into the modern era while staying true to its style more. And humor. Compulsion and In Exile shared their first original experiences since joining Xbox with South of Midnight and Clockwork Revolution. And we are thrilled at how Avowed is shaping up for release next year from the RPG masters at Obsidian.
Obsidian.
In addition to Avowed, our studios will deliver Hellblade 2, an all-new Microsoft Flight Simulator, Towerborn, and more in 2024.
Later this month,
players can look forward to Elder Scrolls Online Necrom and Sea of Thieves Monkey Island. As we look to holiday, we will launch Starfield and Forza Motorsport, both built for Xbox Series X, S, and PC. We are also honored to share 14 games today from our creative partners, like Star Wars Outlaws from Ubisoft Massive.
Please say, but we have one more trick up our sleeve. Oh, and by the way,
Thunder Lotus,
do something cool, man.
Mitsugami, Path of the Goddess from Capcom, and more Persona games coming to Game Pass thanks to our continued partnership with Sega Atlas. I'd also like to congratulate the Studio Zero team on Metaphor ReFantazio. It's great to be able to premiere what is next from the creators of Persona here in our showcase. We are focused on putting our players and game creators first in everything we do.
All right.
No matter if you choose to play on Xbox, PC, or over the cloud, all gamers are welcome here at Xbox.
Nice.
When it comes to our consoles, we have heard your feedback on two fronts. First, we have significantly increased our supply of Xbox Series X, making it easier for fans to find globally.
Okay.
Second, we know you've wanted more storage with Xbox Series S, and I'm excited to share we have some news there as well.
What? I thought this already happened. Oh, they're just selling one with 1 terabyte or whatever? The Elite, Xbox S Elite. Now with 1 terabyte. That'd be cool if it's still the same price. $350, not bad. Not bad at all.
And now for the one more thing you've all been waiting for.
All right, here we go.
Prepare for the most comprehensive deep dive we've ever done for the biggest game we've ever built. So sit tight and enjoy Starfield Direct.
Oh, really? So, okay. So just will start. Starfield's really, really the thing. I guess because it's like the nearest thing. I mean, I don't know if I really want to go through Starfield. Honestly, it's been an hour. I don't know, Hollow Knight? No Halo stuff? Woke Box? That's so stupid.
Everyone, thank you so much for joining us today, and welcome to Bethesda Game Studios.
You know, we've been so lucky over the decades to make the kind of games that we love here. And that's thanks to all of you, from the Elder Scrolls to Fallout. We love creating these worlds and playing in them just as much as you do. And throughout all that time, we'd often talk about and dream up the space game. What if we could take that feeling of being who you want to be and exploring a new world?
Hey, nice computer you got there.
Space, where you weren't really limited in where you could go or what you could do. And that is Starfield. Obviously, we've come a long way since then. With the games we've built, our technology, and all of us here in the studio, we've done so much together, but, well, we've never tried to make a game like this. Today, you'll get to hear from many on the team and see so much.
So I'm guessing this is not a
game special.
I think it's because it's so long in production. I always thought they already had one. That's how fucking literally 20 something years.
Starfield is our first new universe in over 25 years, but it's still a Bethesda RPG through and through, where you step into a new world and you get that feeling of unlimited possibilities. But this time, it's not just one world. It's over 1,000 worlds.
1,000.
The choice of where to go, it's not ours, it's yours. And it wasn't until now that we had the technology to create it. From the rocks at your feet to the mountains in the distance.
I would have to assume they're creatures procedurally generated.
That isn't just a backdrop. That moon is actually there orbiting the planet. Yes, you can visit it too. We realistically simulate the galaxy around you. Our next generation lighting model uses real-time global illumination to light the world based on the type of star and the makeup of the planet's atmosphere.
Cool.
We also have an all-new animation system. And of course, you can play it in third person. And you can play it in first person.
That's nice to get both.
We love exploration and rewarding it, but you do explore differently in this game, given its scale. That usually involves exploring an area you've landed in. You can collect resources, do a mission, and maybe even stumble upon something unexpected.
Abandoned mine? Whoa. Okay. Ooh, that's a hell of a jump. Alright, the combat looks kind of fast-paced. That's good. It almost looks like Halo, honestly. It's kind of funny.
We do love stuff and all of the items allowing you to pick everything up. And you can view all that in your data menu. This is the hub for everything you're doing, from your skills to your ship,
refine
your missions,
Eon,
and
what is it?
Your inventory. We love to pack a ton of detail in every object, from all of your weapons to spacesuits to food. We just obsess over the details.
Wow.
Food. We obsess over food. When you're done exploring, you can walk back or fast travel to your ship.
Yeah, there's no way there's going to be 60 frames.
And crew you can take with you. I left Vasco here back at my ship.
Welcome back, Captain Howard.
And he can even say your name. Let's head out.
I think he can say your name. Like, imagine, like, all this AI voice shit going on, and, like, come on, man.
Of space exploration, to evoke the romance of the golden age of early spaceflight. And we've been referring to this approach as NASA Punk. This means a design language where the tech is advanced, yet still looks grounded and relatable.
For us, it's that contrast. That's where the visual interest is. Obviously, the NASA, which is the rigid, hard, function over style, and then punk, which is all about style.
You can see that visual style coming through in your ship. Your ship is your home for you and your crew. And like many of the spaces in our game, it has a slightly retro and analog touch. a bit of lo-fi rather than sci-fi, where everything is well-used, worn, and lived in.
Alrighty. What's the plan,
Makes sense.
Captain?
This I like that. Like, Spider-Man did that. That was really good.
The planet you're currently on. You can see all of its info and resources. You can choose a landing spot or fast travel to known locations. Backing out further, you can view all the planets in the system. Obviously, the game is big, and it's here you can see planets that have key locations, missions, or life on them.
Dude, that star is... I know they can't make it normal to scale, but if the star was there, everything would be destroyed.
Here, you can plot a course to ones that are light years away. This uses your ship's grav drive to fold space and jump to these systems. And you will need to upgrade your ship and skills if you want to jump to the most distant ones. But for now, we'll plot a course to the Alpha Centauri system, where we can find the city of New Atlantis.
Jumped. Whee!
Welcome to UC Space. Maintain your current course while we scan your ship's cargo.
Yeah, alright.
Scan complete. You are cleared for landing at New Atlantis.
Cool, thank you. You must pay an excise tax. Oh, sweet. I wonder if they'll do something stupid like that, or cost money to land.
As you land in a city like New Atlantis, your eyes are guided upwards to just these boundless, vast buildings.
It's the biggest city we've ever made. Not just in size, but also in the amount of custom art, crowds, and quests.
So the main focus when we're designing a city is obviously what supports the story. We try and tell as many small stories as possible.
This is a Colony War memorial.
It's a few moments of gameplay that make the space feel like it's full of real characters that are going about their day-to-day lives.
It's paralyzing if you really stop and think about it.
Buddy, it's coffee.
It's also
Buddy,
where
it's
your
coffee.
Adventure with Constellation begins.
Welcome to Constellation.
Man, I feel like they had like 25 years of like storytelling to make this work.
Group. Most people don't even know they exist anymore. They're the last true explorers in the galaxy, and they're trying to find the answers to some of humanity's biggest questions.
The artifacts are so different, so alien, and I'm certain one of them reached out and spoke to you.
Seems too good to be true. Oh, gosh, man.
The artifact. If you could place it on the table here.
Oh my god. Look at how it's coming together.
Oh my god.
Built by an intelligence outside the
Oh my god.
Systems. It's definitely an eclectic cast of characters. You've got Sarah Morgan, the ex-soldier and adventurer, now Constellation's...
All right, I've seen enough. The game looks cool. Who believes Tell a lot going on with it. Else out there. Noelle, I will definitely play
scientist
it.
And Sarah Morgan's protege. And
Maybe.
Walter, a very successful businessman in the settled systems.
But yeah, I don't want to get spoiled by it either.
Like, anything goes as long as you have the money.
I mean, how can you get spoiled, honestly? But Sam Cohen, I don't know, I just kind of want to not know. Oh my god, Red Dead Redemption 3.
You know
anyway,
I
have to wake up. It's too early for me.
Otherwise irresistible charm.
The journey you take
Where's
with
this?